So this is it, guys. This is the big one. This is what we've all been waiting for. And most of all, this is what flair bartending is all about. After 5 World Opens, 4 UK Challenges, 1 UK Final, here we are. Five competitors have qualified for this two-day event, which will contain one working flair round, one exhibition flair round, where the top 6 of which will go through to the grand final, where they have to step it up and bring their best to become the 2010 Roadhouse World Champion.
Right, guys, welcome to Roadhouse 2010 Grand Finals.
We want to see something new.
I'm looking for an overall package.
Crowd interaction.
Brand new routines. Something that's pushing boundaries.
Skill, difficulty, variety.
Drink making techniques, the recipes.
The confidence on stage.
Composure, entertainment.
You've got to get a right mix, almost like a cocktail.
Of course, working flair. That's, to me, that's the main thing.
It's not all about the flair. It's also about, you know, your sort of rapport with the customers and stuff.
Whether or not you can work a bar, entertain people whilst being professional.
They have to train and practice a lot.
You've got to have great technical skills, great variety, but you've got to be a showman at the same time.
To be on the stage at Roadhouse is a very particular feeling.
It's terrifying up there.
It has a big crowd, the place is packed with people.
Everything is like, you know, close. You have the crowd right there, right in front of you.
If you've got the crowd on your side, it makes it that much easier for you.
It's the biggest atmosphere for any competition around the world.
It's very intimidating.
You have to be very strong mentally to beat that pressure.
Where is it going to end? I mean, you know, people are kicking off with multiple objects and working flair straight off the bat, you know, no holding back.
The standard, it's just madness. What these guys are doing, you know, you can see the hours of practice that's going into it.
For the untrained eye, it's very difficult to follow, to even know how many objects they have in their hands.
The fact that people are landing their big moves on the music, on a stage, in front of 500-600 people.
If we go back like 4 or 5 years ago, I mean, the level today is unbelievable.
4 years ago, I thought that we are on the top, but we are not even close.
First of all, you know, it's the name, so it gives people that pressure because it's a classic. You know, it's one of those competitions that, you know, everybody wants to win.
Everyone want to be here.
I think it's the whole venue of it, the whole underground thing of it.
The standard of the flair bartenders that come to the Roadhouse Cons are, you know, out of this world.
It's a real stature to win this competition. It's one of the ones that everybody wants to win.
The crowd is full of bartenders. Everyone knows flair.
Once you win Roadhouse, you get that respect, not only in Europe, but all over the world.
So guys, we're actually inside the Roadhouse at the stage, as you can see behind me. About an hour, the first competitor is going to kick off. Slowly, there's the people walking in, places filling up, and there's lots of nervous bartenders walking around me. I'm sitting here with the man who made it all possible this year, Mr. Ollie Block. Ollie, good to see you again. How are you?
Yeah, I'm all right, mate. You say nervous bartender.
How are your nerves?
Nervous organizer. Yeah, no, I'm good, man. I'm good. It's just a lot to do and a lot to... These guys are great. They've been so warming and they're making my job a lot easier. I'm speaking fast because I've just got so much to do and it's exciting, but the working flair's about to kick off. But yeah, good to get you guys back in the building.
Yeah, good to be here, man. Can you tell us a bit on the rundown for the 2 days? What's going to happen? How's it going to be looking like?
Yeah, basically what we're doing is we've all the guys picked the names out of a hat last night for the running order. So Darren Doimo went on first. He was like, oh, so he's a bit gutted. Sylvain second, but it's only fair. So the working flair's going to go on. They've got 3 minutes. They have to make 2 drinks, which are blind. So there's 4 drinks in total. They pick 2 at random and they have to turn them over and they have 5 minutes to look through those drinks. Then they have to make 3 minutes. So we've got 22 competitors from all over the world. 3 minutes apiece, working flair. It's going to go off.
It's the big one.
It's huge.